Hello everyone, how are you doing? It's nice to see you again today. In the previous lesson about modal verbs, you learned how to use could, should, and would correctly. Today, I will teach you three more common modal verbs in English, including can, may, and must. So, are you ready to begin the lesson? Let's get started. So, what are modal verbs? Modal verbs are auxiliary verbs that can provide additional and specific meaning to the main verb of a sentence. For example, when your boss says, "You must finish your project in 2 weeks." Finish is the main verb and must is the modal verb. So that means it's your duty or your responsibility to finish your project in 2 weeks. If not, you might get in trouble. Okay, is it clear everyone? Now, let me explain how to use may, can, and must correctly in English. 1. Can. Can is used to express an authority to do something. For example, you can use your books while doing this test. I can take a 40-minute break every morning. To express permission, you can call me now. You can take a holiday next week. To express an ability, I can drive a car. She can swim. He can play soccer. To express astonishment or surprise. For example, can he be right? Can she be waiting for him now? She can't be waiting for him now. To make a polite request. Can I ask you a question? Can I borrow your book, please? Okay, is it clear, everyone? 2. May. May is used to express an authority to do something. For example, you may smoke in this restaurant. You may park your car on this street. To express permission, you may attend a music class next year. You may take a nap now. To express supposition with doubt. For example, we may be able to fix your car tomorrow. You may be able to improve your English more quickly if you practice every day. May is also used in the present perfect tense to express possibility that happened in the relative past. For example, I may have passed the math exam, but I didn't have a calculator. She may have arrived at work on time, but she missed the bus. 3. Must. Must is used to express obligation. For example, you must turn right here because it's a one-way street. You mustn't use inappropriate language in school. To express a firm necessity. For example, you must stop eating late at night if you want to lose weight. I mustn't smoke if I want to have good health. to express a logical conclusion. For example, you have a lot of good marks in university. You must be very smart. The soccer team won the tournament. They must be very elated. Must is also used in the present perfect tense to express a probability or a presumption of the past actions that relate to the present. For example, the water is dripping. I must have forgotten to shut it off. My son left the house an hour ago. He must have arrived at the school. Is it clear, everyone? Now, let's move on to some practice. Practice A. Please choose the correct answer to complete the sentence. 1. Right, B is the correct answer. I can meet you in an hour. 2. Yes, C is the correct answer. You may purchase tickets for the show tomorrow. 3. Yes, the correct answer is C. She may have gotten a promotion, but she was absent last week. 4. Yes, the correct answer is A. You mustn't smoke on the airplane. 5. Yes, A is the correct answer. Look, the stove is still warm. Someone must have been here. Practice B. Please choose the correct answer to complete the sentence or question. 1. Yes, A is the correct answer. Can you give me a tour of your home? 2. Right, B is the correct answer. It may rain tomorrow, so be prepared. 3. Right, C is the correct answer. You must pay your tuition fees by the deadline. 4. Right, the correct answer is B. He may have finished his project, but he was sick. 5. Yes, A is the correct answer. Look, it's 10 a.m. and she's still sleeping. She must have stayed up late last night. Good practice, everyone. So, how were your answers, everyone? Did you get the right answers? Good. I hope you now have a better understanding of how to use can, may, and must correctly. Now, please share this video with your family and friends, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel to learn more English lessons. Hope to see you again in the next video. Bye bye!